this entitled Jellyfish Logging Events, a Particle Tracking Model Approach. In reality, it's the citizen science and the particle tracking model approach. I work in HydroMod. My presentation will be more a practical one. Basically, we have a problem in Israel that there is a lot of desalinization plants in the Israel coast. We have a lot of power plants that use sea as the a cold source to the refrigeration system. So these are infrastructures that are very critical for the state of Israel, and they depend on the behavior of the jellyfish, because jellyfish tend to clog these systems. They usually these industrial facilities, they pump a lot of water, and some of them, the nuclear ones, cannot be shut down. So this is quite a problem. I think I've then take some frames in from this YouTube video that is explained very well the problem. So you can have these jellyfish swarms events that they are huge. Then this when the intake, if you have an intake that pumps 10 cubic meters per second, you have this jellyfish coming to the intake, clogging the intake area. In this case, they have a system, a very complex system that basically uses clean up the intake area, brings the jellyfish up, put it in the channel, then put it in these big boxes, and then a truck take it away. So this is system. This is it's a big problem. There is a lot of money put to avoid this problem, and this is what we want to allow to improve the operation. This operation. So our main goal, our ideal goal, was to give them some kind of alert so they can be prepared for the event. In the base of this work, we are using a citizen. We are based all the work in this citizen science monitoring program, a very very good citizen. Basically, it has a web app. It's been working since 2011. It has in the database more than 20,000 reports. With a lot of information about the species at distance from the coast, the density a lot. It has an army of almost 5,000 users submitting reports. They usually it's in a daily base, and 500 trained to that are more experienced and are able to give better information. This is all we are. There is a lot of formal science behind this. The DORI team has many papers where they try to base this crossing the citizen science with the numerical models, particle tracking models, as DNA analysis. There's very extensive literature done by this team that is supporting us in our efforts. Okay, what is the Iliad goal? Basically, is as I said already, to support water intake operations. Basically, we want to provide a platform where we can merge the citizen science observations with the particle tracking model. We are working in Iliad with other pilots. We are working also with an aquaculture pilot that is focused in aquaculture in Italy, another in Tunisia, and the ocean engine in Scotland. So I'm going to only to talk about Israel jellyfish case. We have already a site where you can play with the tool. So our general methodology will be to use citizen science observations, the knowledge of the DORI Edlis team, and use the marine Copernicus that you have already in a nice presentation. In this case, we are using the MedSea forecasting system. Use this forecast. Now we are only focusing on the surface currents, but we want also to look at primary production, temperature, etc. And then run a particle tracking model where we can, in the observations location, define an emission and to see what can be the trajectory of inert particles that are transported by the surface currents. this is our starting. It's not the starting, we have already done some work. So what we want to deliver in this first step, a platform, what you call it, which will be our basic goal. It's this platform that is able to do forecasts. This is a forecast that I've done for today, one day forward. And we want to add to this platform, already working, a link to the database, the citizen science database. So, for example, the user can see what in the last 15 days, what was the observations, and do some kind of hypothesis and to see, okay, if this guy in a kayak observes something like this, it's a big swarm, where the CMEMS circulation model says that it can be transported. It's near a desalinization, near a power plant, a beach, whatever. But our final goal was to have this platform, but also to have some kind of alert system that based in this particle tracking trajectories, based in temperature, that it's a trigger, because if the temperature is too high, the jellyfish tend to die and then to be transported. It's not able to have an agency to be able to go against the current, so it can be transported to the coast. So the idea was to do enough. So how are we going to try to forecast these clogging events? This is under analysis, but our focus is to do statistical analysis of particle tracking, temperature and particle production model results. Now we are focusing on the particle tracking. There is literature that connects the Nilo area, the Nilo coastal area with the Israel. So apparently it looks like the jellyfish, the origin of some of the jellyfish is the Nile, is this coastal area near the Nile. Makes sense because it's a source of nutrients, so it makes sense. So what we are doing is we are running a particle tracking model. We are emitting in the Nile area particles in the offshore area, in the coastal area, and to see how the particles, the particles are reaching the coast and the shelf, and to see if the time variability that we are getting and makes sense with the citizen science observations. For example, if we cross for particles emitted in a specific area, we are able to have this increase in density particles reaching the coast in the same time that they were reporting these events in the media. So this is something that we are analyzing, and we are going to go to temperature. But this, we don't know if we will be able to do it, but it's our effort to have an alert that can be sent whenever there is the conditions, the meteorographic and the biogeochemical conditions for a clogging event. So this power plants and desalination can be ready to. We have implemented many forecasting systems in very areas in the world. And for example, this is very similar with the system that we had for macroalgae. Again, and this helped a lot the power plant to organize their activities and to be ready for the problem. Okay. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Paolo.